We still talk about Louis Riel. We don't talk about Harry Daniels. We don't talk about the contemporary issues and the struggles we've had as leaders in our communities for the last 30, 40, 50, 60 years.
Historically, since 1850, the acts have changed from the British Parliament through to the Indian Act of 1876, the subsequent changes of 1951, so on and so forth, up to 1982. The changes have always been instituted or written by and enacted by the settler governments, or the imperial governments first of all, and then the settler governments in Canada. It's a policy of extermination, it's a policy of further shrinking the definition of what an Indian is.
You don't know what went on in the 50s and the 60s, and how we had to fight for welfare rights and core funding and housing and demonstrations every day. No, young people don't know what's going on. They just talk about Riel and Dumont.
We have to have someone speaking on behalf of our people, articulating our wants and needs and our aspirations. As long as there are unresolved questions, unresolved wants and needs, we have to have an organization that is going to, that is well equipped, first of all, and to articulate those wants and needs. And if we don't have that, then we're just gonna, you know, disappear as a race of people. They're creating their own skid row. They're creating a community of lost souls in the bush, and that's not good.
So you got to be careful how you identify yourself. Either you're an Indian or you're not an Indian. You're a Métis or you're not a Métis. You're an Inuit or you're not an Inuit. And you've got to see the Indian Act was only put together for the administrative purposes of defining who an Indian was for the white people of this country. So now we got all our Indian leaders running around saying, well, we're full-blooded Indians. Well, that's a crock of crap too. Because I got a lot of cousins on those reserves who are Métis and mixed blood like I am, running around with treaty numbers. And I don't begrudge them that. I'm happier than hell for them. But they shouldn't be running us down because we don't have treaty numbers, or else we're not as good Indians as them because they got a number over there somewhere that satisfies the needs of a white government.
During the repatriation of the Constitution in 1981, President Harry Daniels argued for and won the inclusion of the words Indian, Métis, and Inuit into the Constitution of Canada.
Rich Hen was making the deal, and I asked him, I said, well, who are these Aboriginal people? Well, he said, you people here, the Indians, the Inuit, the Métis, so put that in the Constitution.
What we are talking about is the equality of people here. And to use your phrase, we're talking about a just society. It can't be just for some Aboriginal people and not for others. Together with the representatives of the Indian and Inuit peoples, we agree that the word Métis would be recognized in the Constitution as Aboriginal peoples. Mr. Chairman, I'm a Métis from Regina Beach, Saskatchewan, who is proud of his Aboriginality and who believes that every person of Native ancestry, from whatever Indian stock and from whatever corner of this great country, has a special place in the Constitution in Section 35.
What are you guys talking about over there?
The old church bell at the Tosh. You know, the one the soldiers stole after the resistance in 1885.
Oh, yeah, and they took it to Ontario.
They say that thieves were driving a red truck with Saskatchewan license plates, Alcid.
You think I stole it? You know I don't steal. I've never stolen a thing in my life.
Make a living any way they can. Where Red River Jig is the blood of the land. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Old Uncle Gabe, he laid in the shade. The smoke from his pipe turned blue. And the stories he told made your blood run cold. He swore by God they were true. He remembers when he bought Middleton's men. He did it all for me and you. And late one night when the moon was shining bright, he even fought the Rougarou.
Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Try to make a living any way they can. Where Red River Jig is the blood of the land. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Old Uncle Gabe, he laid in the shade. The smoke from his pipe turned blue. And the stories he told made your blood run cold. He swore by God they were true. He remembers when he bought Middleton's men. He did it all for me and you. And late one night when the moon was shining bright, he even fought the Rougarou.
Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Try to make a living any way they can. Where Red River Jig is the blood of the land. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man. Rubber boo woman loves a rubber boo man.
Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exception. I planned each charted course, each careful step. Along the byway, oh, and more, much more than this.
I did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, no, not me, I did it my way. Oh, what is a man, what has he got, if not himself?
It's 34 years since the organization formed, and Harry Daniels is one of the founding people and has been actively involved in the organization for many years. He was the CEO of the organization for 2 years and also vice president at one time. We were then called the Native Council of Canada. So for me, and it's at this particular time, it's a real honor to be overseeing the dedication of the building in honor of Harry. The board of directors of the Congress very befittingly, I believe, decided to dedicate the building in recognition of all that Harry has done for all Aboriginal peoples. He was very instrumental in getting the rights of Aboriginal peoples in the Constitution. And I've admired the guy right from day one. He was quite a bit of a mentor of mine, and I'm very pleased to see this happening in recognition of Harry.
It takes people to change things. People like you. Get involved. Speak to your governments. It's a question of fairness. Thank you.